After days of social media circus, news media hype, and personal barb from Jeff Bezos' Blue Origin, space tourism company Virgin Galactic today made history by sending in space the first billionaire founder of a space company. It was none other than the bossman of Virgin Galactic, the eccentric billionaire Sir Richard Branson.
The name's Branson. Sir Richard Branson, astronaut 001.
The event lived up to the hype. The guest list featured a number of celebrities and high-profile people from the industry, including SpaceX honcho Elon Musk, Canadian astronaut Chris Hadfield, musical artist Khalid, and space researcher Kelly Girardi. While Richard Branson has downplayed any suggestions of a space race, the social media has been abuzz over the bragging rights Branson has earned by beating rival billionaire Jeff Bezos to space by 9 days. Bezos is due to make his space excursion aboard his company Blue Origin's New Shepard rocket on July 20th. With today's flight, Richard Branson realized a long-cherished dream of going to space as he took off with his crew and co-passengers on board spacecraft Unity, which was carried up to an altitude of more than 45,000 feet by a carrier aircraft called VMS Eve.
I was once a child with a dream, looking up to the stars. Now I'm an adult in a spaceship with lots of other wonderful adults looking down to our beautiful, beautiful Earth.
The mission included two pilots, Dave Mackay and Michael Masucci, and four passengers including Sirisha Bandler, Colin Bennett, Beth Moses, and Richard Branson himself. The launch took place from the company's operations hub at Spaceport America in New Mexico. The high-profile event, hosted by comedian Stephen Colbert, was watched live by millions of space enthusiasts around the world and lived up to its top billing. The only unsavory incident related to the space flight came in the form of a petty and petulant put-downer by Blue Origin in a Twitter post yesterday. The tweet got an immediate and blistering backlash from Space Twitter that wasted no time in slamming BO's tweet. Central to the two billionaires' dispute is the fact that the line where space begins is not a universally agreed upon altitude. Anyway, back to Virgin Galactic's first fully crewed flight. At an altitude of more than 45,000 feet, the carrier aircraft Eve released the Unity aircraft, which fired its rocket engine and skyrocketed to more than 3 times the speed of sound. After performing a slow backflip in microgravity at the edge of space, reaching an altitude of nearly 90 kilometers, Unity returned through the atmosphere in a glide to the runway of Spaceport America. Branson said a few days ago, upon returning from space, he would announce something very exciting to give more people the chance to become an astronaut. Because space belongs to us all. We're all waiting to hear that announcement with bated breath. Thanks for watching. See you next time.